Autism Ontario, it's Shawna, and today I'm going to be showing you how to make my favorite holiday treat, shortbread cookies. For this recipe, you are going to need butter that's been left out and softened, icing sugar, cornstarch, and flour. An additional ingredient that you may want to include is holiday-themed sprinkles, which we will use to decorate our shortbread cookies if you wish. For materials, you will need a large mixing bowl, a small plate or bowl, as well as a fork, and a baking tray lined with parchment paper. You are going to want to preheat your oven to 350 degrees and wash your hands really, really well because we'll be using them to mix all of our ingredients together. Your ingredients list, as well as materials and steps, will be popping up on your screen shortly, and I'll see you back here in a minute to get started. So once you've preheated your oven and washed your hands, we're going to start combining our ingredients into our big mixing bowl. So the additional 1/4 cup of flour is going to go into your small bowl or plate, and you're just going to put that off to the side. We're going to need that a little bit later when we're done mixing our dough. So we're going to start by adding our butter that's been softened into our bowl, and next our flour. And finally, our icing sugar and cornstarch. This is where we're gonna get a little bit messy because we're going to be using our hands to mix in the dough for our shortbread. So if your butter's nice and soft, it shouldn't be too hard. And you're going to wanna mix all of your ingredients and your butter together until it makes a nice, soft, smooth dough. When your dough is ready, it'll look something like this. And we're gonna start by taking a small chunk of our dough and rolling it in our hands to make a ball. When it comes out, it should be something like this, and it should be approximately the size of a toonie. And when you've got it ready, you're gonna put it on your parchment paper, and you're gonna complete this step over and over and over again until your parchment paper is full. Now, just a reminder, you're going to want them about 1 inch apart on your baking tray. Once your tray is filled with your dough balls, you're going to grab your small bowl or plate that you've put your extra flour on with your fork, and you're just going to lightly cover your fork in flour, and then you're going to press down on your dough ball in one direction, and then add a little bit more flour and press down the other direction. And you're going to keep doing this step until you've completed with all of your cookie dough balls. When you've finished flattening down all your cookies, you may choose to leave them like this, or you can add sprinkles. So right now I'm going to add, on half of mine, I'm going to add some red sprinkles. And you don't need too much, just a little bit on top to give it some color. And when you're happy with them, you can put them in the oven for 8 minutes or until they're golden brown. Now, these can be really tricky cookies, so you need to make sure that you're watching them the whole time that they're in the oven to make sure that they don't burn. When your cookies are finished baking in the oven, you're going to want to leave them out to cool for at least 10 minutes before transferring them onto a plate. When they are done, they should look something like this, and you'll notice that the top color hasn't changed a lot, but underneath is a nice golden brown color. Thanks so much for joining me today, everybody. I hope you have a very safe and happy holiday season.